Hello guys and welcome back to Epic Mentorship. In today's video, I want to share with you how to make a drop-down list from Microsoft Excel so that it can look something like this. Once you click, you will be able to see the options that you have and select from the option just using a Microsoft Excel. So to start with, let's try to create a question that we can easily use to answer to put in the range of answers that we have in the drop down list. So assuming you are asked this question, who is your best friend? And we try to resize this to fit in the content. So who is your best friend? And we expect your answer to be here. Okay, so you put your answer here. You have to choose from a range of options. So assuming we have your options down here, you have options Salisu, Tanimu, Muhammad and Saddam. Who is your best friend? And you have to write the answer here. So coming over to the cell where you want to have the drop down list containing these as the options, you can just click on it and then navigate from home all the way to data over here. Okay, once you get to data, you can come over to this drop down menu. Okay, you can click on it. You can see data validation. You just select. Make sure this cell is selected before you get to data validation. Okay, so you click on data validation, and over here you have a range of options. You have the settings where you allow the validation criteria. The first validation criteria is we allow a series of files from here, so we can say we allow only lists. So we can say it to ignore blank and in cell drop down. This has to be an in cell drop down, so you have to make sure you tick this. It's an in cell drop down, and the source of the data, it has to be a range. Okay, so range means we click on this and then we select the range of the data. You can select all the ranges that you have according to the arrangement of your drop down menu. So once you're finished, you click on this arrow and you have it selected here. You have the input message. So what do you want to put as an input message? So we can just put, okay, we can put in input hint, and then we can put in the message here, choose. So this is the message that will appear on the cell before you click on the drop down. Once you click on this cell, you're going to see the drop down, the list in the drop down. But before you choose, you can say choose here. So this is the message. And then if there is an error, assuming you put in something that is not in the list, it should tell you stop, or you can decide to show error alert after an invalid data is entered. So you can show the style by showing a warning. Maybe you should show a warning, and then the message can be it will as error, and then you can say invalid entry. You can say invalid entry, and once you click on OK. Okay, so once you finished, you selected everything, then you can go ahead and click on OK. So this cell is going to have a drop down list. So once you are in this cell, you click on the drop down, you can see the options that we have just created. So once you are in here, you can select a particular option and it's going to show. So any option you select is going to show, and if you like, you can select this and make it available for all the cells that you have, for a given range of cells. All you need to do is to come over to this small squared item down here until your cursor turns to this cross sign. So you can drag it down up to the number of cells that you want, and it's going to take in all this drop down. So if you wanted to take Muhammad, it will take, or it will take something different. If you wanted to take Muhammad, it will take, and you can drag and it will take. Or you want to take Salisu, it will take and drag, and you will have Salisu all the way. And if you don't want anything as a selection, you can delete. For example, here you can delete, or you can delete this content, but you can still drag the content to show blank, or to show blank selection until the end of. But in each case, if you touch, you can still see the drop down just the way it is on each one. Once you click, you can see the drop down and you select accordingly. So this is how to create a simple drop-down list from Microsoft Excel. Ladies and gentlemen, if you enjoyed this video, remember to hit the like and subscribe button to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.